Placing grass in outdoor environments by hand is tedious, so in this tutorial you will learn how to set up 3 levels of procedural grass from basic to a bit more complex. Let's get right into it. First of all, the prerequisites for this tutorial are a landscape and the landscape material. How this material is set up doesn't really matter as long as you have this node, which will let us paint on a landscape, and you will see why this is so important in just a bit. For this first level, let's start simple and get grass and ferns over the entire landscape. So for that, let's get into the material, and we are going to search for a node called landscape grass output. Now for each grass type that we will want to display, this node is going to require a name and a grass type. Currently we don't have a grass type set up, so let's see what that is. Let's minimize this, go to the content browser, right click, and then go to foliage and landscape grass type. And I'm simply going to call this grass. Let's open it up, and in order to actually add a grass type, we'll have to add an array element to this grass varieties array. The only setting that we will really have to change is the grass mesh, and the others are just tweaks so we can make this look better. For example, we can increase the density, or we can play with the culling distance, which basically means how far away grass is going to stop appearing. And keep in mind that you can use whatever assets you have and want to use. Before going ahead and tweaking all these settings, let's go ahead and actually display this on the landscape. So let's go to the content browser, click on the grass type, go back to the material and click on the grass output node, and now click on this arrow. You are going to notice that we are getting an error, and that is because we need to tell the engine where we want this grass to appear. What we can do to fix this is search for layer sample and then plug this inside this input node. Now this is going to require a name, and this name comes from this layer blend node. And this is basically why this node is so important. I'm going to go ahead and copy grass plane, which is basically my entire landscape, and paste this in the parameter name. And now once we are going to apply, we will be able to see the grass spawning. And you can already see the grass spawning. Now let's go ahead in the grass type and tweak some settings, because right now there's way too much grass. And not only that, but the culling is also very visible around here. So let's open it up. And what I want to do is to decrease the density for all of these. First of all, I'll set the grass density to 60. And for the ferns, this is going to be 30. And for the distant grass, this is going to be 50. Now for the end cull distance for the distant grass, I'm going to add one more zero. And now let's save and see how this looks. So you can already see how much farther my grass goes and how smoother the culling is. If I'm going to go up close, you will be able to see the ferns and the grass pretty nicely. Now for the second level, you will learn how to create clumps of flowers and add variation in this landscape. And for that you will need a texture like this one. But if you don't have a program like Photoshop or anything alike, this will be available in the description. So before continuing, I'm going to go ahead and copy the grass type 2 times, and now I will include flowers in these. And now one type is going to contain white flowers and the other one is going to contain red flowers. Again, you should use whatever assets you have. So now let's go back to the material and add 2 more array elements to this node. I'm going to name the first one red flowers and the second one white flowers. And now let's plug both of these grass types into their respective slots. Now we have to go ahead and see where do we want to display these. So what I'm going to do is to drag in this texture, and then we will have to play around with the red and green channels of this. First and foremost, we will have to get a texture coordinate node and then multiply this by a scalar parameter. So I will call this variation scale, and the default value should be something really, really low, like 0.01. Now I will plug this in here and this in UVs. Now I'm going to plug the red channel in the red flowers. And now what we can do is get a custom rotator, plug the multiply node in the UVs, and in the rotation angle I'm going to plug 0.25 to get a 90 degree rotation. Then I will copy this texture and plug the red channel in the white flowers. Now let's apply and see how this looks. And we can already start seeing flowers appearing. And you can do so much more from here. For example, instead of rotating the same texture and reusing it, you could store some data in the blue channel. Lastly, for the third level, I'm going to show you how we can create biomes, which basically means applying different grass types for all these layers. I went ahead and created some grass types for a birch biome and a pine biome, so let's see how we can apply this in the material. So let's go ahead and create 5 more array elements. Now quickly, I'm going to plug in all the grass types that we need. Now let's go ahead and copy this node and paste it twice here. Now we will have to change the name. So let's go back to the layer blend, and here I'm going to get this layer and paste it in the first one. Now once again, let's go back, get this name and paste it for the second one. And now we can simply just plug them in their input nodes. So let's go to modes, landscape, paint, and here I'm going to paint pine and then birch. and you can see just how nice this looks. And there is one trick that I want to show you regarding biomes and generally spawning foliage. Let's say that you just wrote some code that is going to procedurally paint slopes. Obviously, I'm not going to write that, so for me it's always going to return 1. But usually, it would return a vector 2 with values 0 and 1, 0 if there's a slope, 1 if there's not a slope. What the material is going to do is override the material from layer blend with the slope textures. But the engine is still going to keep the data as if the slopes were painted with a layer from the layer blend. And with that being said, grass is still going to get spawned there. So we will have to find a way around that. So what we can do to avoid that is get the returning value from where there's a slope or not, keeping in mind that 1 means no slope and 0 means there's a slope, and from there subtract all the other sample layers besides the one we want to have grass on. So let's go ahead and have an example for the grass plane. So as I said, what I'm going to do is subtract from 1 all the other sample layers besides the basic grass plane. So now we are just going to subtract from 1 all these 4. So let's compile and see what result we are going to get. And as you can see, there is absolutely no difference. So again, this is a neat trick that you can apply when you have procedural painting on the material landscape. And this is only the fundamentals of procedural grass. Huge shout out to all my patrons for supporting me this month and helping me do what I love, and especially to these top tier supporters. Avirama FM, Badral Kaktani, Giovanni Pena, Golden Glowmaster, and Leonardo Pereira. To learn more about procedural foliage, I highly recommend you to watch this video right here. And as always, thank you for watching.